Kirby is one of Nintendo's iconic faces. In his last chapter, Kirby Star Allies, is often represented with an halftone pattern. In this video, we try to recreate this effect on Unity. The halftone effect is composed by little dots that represent the lighting. The more shadow is present, the bigger the dot, creating a darker image. Where the model appears very bright instead, they are completely absent. Also, there is an outline that helps to increase the tone effect. To realize the shader, we use the shader graph. Thanks to the Voronoi noise, we created the dots. We set the Voronoi's angles to 0 and exposed the density field in a new parameter. To manipulate the side of the dot, we multiplied the Voronoi's output with a custom parameter and divided it by the number of the Voronoi cells. Using a modulo and a step node, we obtain a sharp division between the dot and the background. Through a lerp node, we assign two different colors to the parts. Then we deal with light. We multiplied the normal vector with the light direction vector. To achieve this, it's necessary a custom node that provides the light informations. Since we are using the Unity 2018.3, we realized that with a C# class, like the Ciro Continisio's example on GitHub. Using a newer Unity version, you can proceed differently with the custom functions, like Ciro suggests us on our Twitter discussion. We use this technique to realize the Zelda's tone shader. We used the 1- node to invert the color, then we focused on the shadow dots. Thanks to a smooth step node, we defined two thresholds to realize a sharp division in the light and obtain a tone effect. With the divide node, we decide how much shadow percentage to show. We multiplied the end result with the value that assigned the size to the dot. In this way, the dot decreased their size approaching the light. To realize the outline effect, we started from a first null node. With the step node, we separated the two colors. Using a lerp node, we decided the color of the edge and assigned the pattern in the inner area. We also added a texture to the basic color. From Sketchfab, we downloaded Kirby's model and we rounded it a bit more using Blender. Once imported, we realized the materials. We inserted the metallic and the smoothness values, and we duplicated the shader to realize an unlit version. This is the final result. and this is the unlit version. Don't forget to subscribe and let us know which effects would you like to see realized. See you next time. Cheers!